Hello world, welcome to this very special DroneLink Basics. In this episode we will discuss panoramas, but not the way you used to. This is going into detail. We will fly a total of 9 panoramas. I will fly 2 panoramas with DEF DroneLink and my Inspire 2. Then I will fly 4 panoramas with DroneLink Standard and my Mavic Pro. Then I will fly 1 panorama as a reference with DJI Go 4 in standard settings. And because it's a different day and it's extremely sunny outside, and sun and snow are never very good friends to take pictures or images, this we also will discuss later, I will do 2 additional flights. One with an altered normal panorama in DroneLink with my Mavic Pro, and then later my standard panorama with the DJI Spark as a reference. The idea started with this panorama. Watch the gray zone. This panorama is an on-the-fly panorama which I did a couple of days ago when it was snowing. As you can see, it is very gray, and there is the problem. In the background sky you see dark gray pillars in the normal background sky. In my opinion, I thought that came due to the spot metering, which is very difficult if you have so much gray, because that is actually where the spot metering is adjusting your color in an image. Here you can see the columns, they are all the way around, only in the sky. So I need to find out what was the reason why I had this. So it was time to play with my panoramas. For this compare we use 3 drones. The Inspire, the Mavic Pro and the Spark. Also, I have used all the panorama settings available in DroneLink. I've also used the DJI Go 4 standard panorama. And therefore, all the panoramas I have done have a different result, and we will discuss them here. Here you see all the panoramas and their settings. To be clear, the elevation for all panoramas was 150 feet or 50 meters. The first panorama is with the Inspire 2, a standard mission made by myself with spot in D-Log. The second pano is the same but without spot. The next one is my Inspire 2 a day later with spot and white balance set to sunny. The next one is my Inspire 2 done without spot or D-Log and white balance sunny. The next is my Mavic Pro standard pano with spot metering. The next one is my Mavic Pro with an on-the-fly panorama mission. The next one is my Mavic Pro with D-Log and spot metering. The next one is my Mavic Pro with 39 images and white balance in sunny. The next one is my Spark with my standard tailor-made pano white balance sunny. And the last one is my Mavic Pro with the standard DJI Go 4 pano setting. Okay, that were all the tests. That was a lot of flying, but I really enjoyed it. So, what did I do? I had 4 flights with my Inspire. 2 flights basically with RAW and spot. What is RAW? RAW means actually uncompressed. D-Log, RAW, there's a lot of other names, NEF for Nikon. So basically all the big companies have their own name. But the effect is the same, it's an uncompressed image. As we all know, JPEG is compressed. What is RAW? RAW or D-Log is in principle an uncompressed image. So you just take your photo as the camera will see it. That means no compression, no color correction, no fiddling around. It is the raw image which you have to process afterwards on your computer. This is something that most professional photographers use. For amateur photographs, it's not that important unless you really go into detail. One of the things you heard a lot in this video is spot metering. I want to emphasize a little bit what that is. So, what is spot metering? Spot metering is a light or a color measured in the center of your sensor, about 1.5% of the surface of your sensor, where the computer or your EMI measures a gray value. And the gray value is exactly the middle between fully black and fully white. So when your sensor measures that color, it will calculate all the colors according to that gray value. So if that gray value changes, your color space will change and you get a different color temperature. If you fly in a summer day where you have, let's say, a lot of normal colors for a city, your sensor will, for example, locate brown for roofs, and it will be an equal color for all your images. That's a good thing. If you do like me in snow, it sees white, maybe 80% white and light gray. So it will measure the color temperature according to that white, which he converts to gray. Actually, that's not good. That's why I don't use spot metering while filming in snow. You can do it, but you have to measure your white balance first before you start flying. It's an easy trick, although with a drone it's a little bit more complicated, but it's doable. I prefer to switch the spot metering off. Why? It just takes the normal metering as with any normal picture and your color balance will be better. That is just my experience. What is my conclusion in this video? It is depending what you want. Is the Inspire 2 the best drone for making a panorama? No, for sure it's not. Is the Mavic Pro the best drone? No, for sure it's not. Every drone has its advantages and disadvantages. Of course, the camera of the Inspire 2 is an extremely good camera, but the lens is just not fit for making panoramas. You have to adjust a lot. I can do it. I'm busy on doing something for my... It's only a 50 millimeter lens, so having the best result of that lens takes a lot of practice. It takes a lot of testing, but we get there. I have noticed, for example, doing a panorama in the snow at 150 feet works perfectly. At 400 feet, it was terrible. So there's a lot of testing to be done. Of course, I will finally make a good panorama setting and I will share that on my DroneLink library. The Mavic Pro is a very good drone for an average panorama. If you just want to take a panorama, the Mavic Pro or similar drones are perfectly to do that. Just use basic settings. Be careful when you do spot metering, be careful when you do RAW, but you can do it. It's up to you. Basically, it's up to you. Smaller drones work fine. Just make sure you have enough images. That is most important. The better your overlap, the more clear your panorama will be. The more pictures is better. You're flying, if you have a 64 gigabyte card and you're using 2 gigabytes or 2.5 gigabytes for your photos, who cares? It just takes 20 seconds longer to shot that other 10 images, which makes your panorama better. Okay, I will share my final panoramas on my website, and of course I will put the link below. I also put a link below where spot metering is extremely good explained, so it's easier to understand with good color samples and everything. So for me, doing a panorama with my Inspire 2, I use the normal color settings. I use white balance in sunny or in cloudy never automatic, because that can ruin your image. Maybe you should reduce your EV value with one stop. It just gives you a little bit more depth, and of course you can clear something out later on in post. If you fly with a Mavic Pro or similar drones, just use your standard settings. You can use spot, but I'm not a fan of using spot metering. Most apps at the moment will provide you with the capability of doing panoramas. I did mine perfectly. I'm happy with it. I know my settings. I can adjust my settings. And that is also one of the reasons why I don't use apps like the DJI Go, just because you have absolutely no control over what you want to do. So I prefer to do things manually. That's why for me DJI Go is no go. Other apps like Litchi, Autopilot, there are a number of other apps. They work fine, you just have to play with it. At the end, it's your panorama and it depends what you want to do with it. If there's any questions, please drop me a comment below and I will try to help you as good as I can. And of course, don't forget to subscribe if you already haven't. And of course, give me a thumbs up. Okay, we will see you in the next video. Bye.